Signed to pick No More Heroes 2 because I was umming and ahhing to get it, and after watching one particular video review, I decided to get it. Then it is the particular price that goes for the Wii, and when I was looking up on CX's website, I was like, oh, okay, I might as well get it because there was like a 10% discount as well for this on the eShop at the moment also. So when I was looking up this, even though that I have played some of the first game, well, I do own this also, but when I was playing the first game, I actually played the PlayStation 3 version of the first game, and then I realised as soon as I was looking it up, just for poops and giggles, yeah, so you're telling me, right, this game that I have, literally in my PS3 collection, that I actually own, on is PlayStation Move compatibility because this has PlayStation Move controls, is whatever price that goes for in my local CEX. Huh. Been having kind of a vinyl kind of day because when I was doing my Christmas shopping, I thought I'd treat myself to quite a few vinyls. And then it is this, not only this vinyl came today along with these really cool snifty sleeves by Big Fudge. And these vinyls came along the same day, because not only this came, but this came along with this one that came from the US of A and I imported, and it's got that funky kind of beats. But yeah, that came from the US of A, and yeah, so I'm building up my vinyl collection as we speak, which is quite nifty. Hey Stephen, I got you a nice Christmas ornament to go in your tree. Ah, thank you. But to be honest though, it's a small tree and I managed to get whatever gubbins, ovens and bulbs, etc. to be able to place on this really small dinky tree. But then again, there's not much meat on its bone to be able to stabilise most of this stuff. Oh, come on, please. It's got a nice S on it. Fine. There should be a bit of space there. Yay! Rocking around Christmas tree. Well, at least he's happy. It's Christmas after all. Since you've been a very, very good boy this year and not touching anyone with this and that going on and staying indoors most of your days, I thought I'd give you a Christmas present a bit early. And it's something particularly that you kind of wanted, since there's a Call of Duty game that came out this year. Really, Mum? You got me the new Call of Duty Black Ops! The new Call of Duty Black Ops! I always wanted the new Call of Duty Black Ops! Yeah, Call of Duty Black Ops. Yes, I did get you Black Ops. It's what you wanted. Because when I went to the store all by myself and trying to figure out what you wanted, I even said to the guy, excuse me, do you have the new Call of Duty? And he was like,
Call of Duty Black Ops.
Yes, it is Call of Duty Black Ops. And then he was like,
well, it's actually 60 odd pounds.
60 odd pounds? I'd have paid 60 odd pounds for this fucking game. And I asked him, well, what's the cheapest Black Ops game you can actually get? And he gave me this.
Just downloaded the new Gears 5 update because of the new DLC campaign thing that's released today. And they added a feature just now where basically you can actually select certain things from the actual game itself. Now I finished the campaign, don't get me wrong, and which is great that I finished it. That way I could just play multiplayer. And more games, honestly to say, must need this feature. And it saves a lot of gigabytes for most people that have unlimited storage. And more games should have this. And I do like this concept of a feature, and because I do go straight to multiplayer when it comes to most games, even though if I don't play or finish the campaign for that matter, but I have finished the campaign for this one, so I might do that. And it saves a number of gigabytes, is whatever gigabytes in total, there's whatever gigabytes, you know, when it comes to certain gigabytes. So many gigabytes! Sorry for the lighting, but it's miserable today. But it's my first time playing Code Vein, and for the very first time, even though it's free on my Xbox Game Pass subscription. And I can honestly say, this is the best character creation, by far, with the best hat editor with a military cap ever, honestly to say. Because I can go like this, that, you know, and turn it upside down, and, you know, even though I've got a stupid weeboo kind of, you know, anime hairstyle, but, you know, this is the best. I can just tilt it. I can tilt the hat.